Well, we're here at the Revive Our Hearts International Ministry Center this morning doing something we haven't done a lot of over the past months, but it's a joy today to have a recording session. We have a couple of dozen friends, partners visiting with us here, and we've been talking about the book of Daniel and a new series we've started called Heaven Rules, and Lord willing, you'll get to hear that series in the fall. But some people have been asking, how's it going with your fiscal year-end project? People have been praying. Here we are. Today is May 24th. Is that right? And we're close to the end of May. We've been trusting the Lord for his provision of $750,000 this month. This is always an important time, this in December, at the end of the year, when we trust God for resources that are more than the average month. And so I want to just give you the most current update I have. Through yesterday, we have met 41% of our fiscal year-end goal. And we're about even with this same time last year in the month of May. And as I mentioned, when it comes to May and December, a huge amount of our year-end response comes not only during that month, but during the last week of that month. Last May, for example, 53% of all that came in the month of May came in the last week of the month. So here we are coming up to the last 10 days of May, and I want to just thank the Lord for what he's provided thus far. Every gift, I'm thinking about a $5 gift that came from an international woman living in a far country who'd been asking the Lord, could she please have something she could give to help with Revive Our Hearts, because it's had such an impact in her life. And she sent $5, and Martin Jones, our director, said to me, I am as thankful for that gift as I am for ones that have lots of zeros attached or more zeros attached to the end of them. Because that woman's heart is for this message, for this ministry. And God takes these loaves and fishes that we're able to give, and he multiplies them, and he uses them to feed multitudes. In fact, earlier in this session, we heard from a couple of sisters, Spanish-speaking sisters, who've been impacted through the ministry of Aviva Nuestros Corazones. And they were telling us about how God is using these Spanish resources and the Spanish ministry in different countries around the world, here in the United States, in Latin America, and in other parts of the world, to take the gospel, get women in the Spanish-speaking world into the Word of God. And some of the fruit of that ministry is here with us today. We have another couple of women here today who have come in from California. They're involved in helping with the translation of Revive Our Hearts into French for the French-speaking women of the world. And that's just here in this room today. But today, all around the world, God is at work. He is moving. He is calling women to freedom and fullness and fruitfulness in Christ because of the different outreaches and resources that your partnership helps to make possible. So thanks for praying with us between now and the end of May. God has been so faithful. Exclamation point. God has been so faithful over these past 20 years, 20 Mays, 20 Decembers, and throughout the COVID environment of this last year, we have seen God's hand, we've seen God's provision, and we trust that in these next days, he's going to provide what is needed for the rest of this month. We trust him to write our story. And thank you so much for praying about that need. And as the Lord prompts, for being a part of that. Thanks so much. Blessings on you.